So the basic idea behind selective breeding, which has been used by people for millennia, is that if you know a characteristic of a parent and you preferentially breed that parent, that you can either amplify or increase the trait you care about. Corals are threatened worldwide by a lot of stressors, but increasing temperatures are probably the most severe. And so that's what our focus is on, is working with parents that are really thermally tolerant. So what that looks like for us is a variety of experiments where we have corals that we know are super hardy and some that we know are more sensitive. We try to make crosses and rear those larvae and then understand how far into the future those corals can survive.
Yeah, there wasn't, yeah, definitely quite a bit of skepticism when we proposed the idea. Many people focused on the risks. We got a lot of comments like, oh, you will lose genetic diversity and you will be worse off if you implement the methods that you propose. There was a lot of ethical comments like, oh, you think you're playing God, you know, by intervening with the reef. Well, we have already intervened with the reef for very long periods of time. All we're trying to do is to repair the damage. So, you know, people often don't see it that way, that, you know, there's no part of the ocean where we cannot detect human influence. So.
So this is where our nursery tables are, and then all along here are our tagged bleached and non-bleached parent colonies.
We are not proposing to introduce any genetic diversity from outside the region. We're really focusing first on as local a scale as possible to try and maintain and enhance what is already there and work with existing genetic variation that is already present on the reef.
See how they're already breaking up a little bit? It's pretty early for them to be doing that. These are the eggs here that are a lot smaller than the egg sperm bundles.
Assisted evolution started out as kind of this crazy idea that you could actually help something change and allow that to survive better because it is changing. There were three different proof of concept ideas with that. One of them was selective breeding. One was acclimation, or what we call kind of conditioning or training the organism. And the other was modifying symbioses. And we really just set out to see if it would work, if any of these crazy ideas could possibly help. And the main reason we did that was because there was no other options. So we're starting to realize that we have to intervene in order to make a change for coral reefs to survive into the future.